Today we finish the main event of the 2009 World Whiskey Tour, Réunion Island, Saint-Pierre-les-Archers.
Your own world rod is TV, and what a day we had. This morning we were able to run the first half of round three of the Open Men's until a storm came through with vicious lightning, and the organisation had no other choice than to cancel the event for 3 hours.
And just after the break, we started the competition in perfect, huge and glassy conditions.
Powerful, perfect waves. So we're really hoping we continue on. I know I'm keen to get out there, I know the others are, and potentially we could have one of the greatest wave ski contests.
Just duck dive, just front of the lip, and the lip, I think, yeah, smashed my wave ski and I touched the reef.
Awesome. I saw Michael taking off on a wave on the inside and I was hooting him. It was actually, I just said to Michael coming down the rocks, it was just like three of us free surfing out there. It was just unreal. I've been on a wave ski contest now for only 8 years or 7 years, and I've been dying for a contest over 3 foot. Well, I got my over 3 foot today, so I'm just stoked. This is a dream.
Off the highlights today, you couldn't go past Michael Osborne from South Africa. He was the form surfer of the whole competition today, and it was a phenomenal wave he got in the semi-final. Michael scored a 9.75 on what was the best wave of the day.
Once you're on them, they're just amazing. They're absolutely amazing. Like Ben was saying, you wait for years to have a contest in such good surf, such epic, powerful surf. Yeah, it was just amazing. It was like a social out there with Ben and I and Renault.
I'm here with Ben John, who finished third at the second leg of the World Whiskey Tour 2009 in Réunion Island. So Ben, it was crazy action today. And as a charger, you finished well. So what's your feeling now?
I'm stoked. I'm just stoked we had the contest today in great conditions. Good for the sport.
Okay, I'm with Blair Moore. You finished fourth of this leg, Blair. It was better than the first one, I think.
Yeah, it's much better. There's great waves out there today. Unfortunately, I couldn't really go for it. I've still got probably 6 months of rehab to do on my shoulder. But I saw some great surfing, and it was probably the most awesome waves I've ever seen for a contest.
Well, we have to talk about Matthew Barbaret today. Well, he's known as the king, and he really was the king. He stood up today, and it started off a big day for him in the quarterfinal. Things didn't go too well for him. He actually broke his board and hit his face on the rocks on the inside section there.
and he managed to get up and going again. I saw him get trashed the whole semi-final, and I thought he was gone. And he scraped through there, and he got to the final against a hot in-form Michael. He was going to be really hard to beat. And Matthew, to his credit, stood up and surfed incredible with top to bottom vertical surfing. I think he got an 8 and a 6, which in total would have been the highest score of the day, and he did that in the final. And to do that, he really showed his true colours today. We are one of our now.
Kind of gritted our teeth and told them to get out there, and they pulled it off. It was incredible. We got to see the most amazing riders surfing the most incredible left-hander I've seen in a final the whole time I've been judging, which has been far too long, actually. We are one of our now.
Second place, incredible, mate. I've got to say, you were the form surfer of this second leg with these conditions. You were just, mate, you're a powerhouse out there. You must have had the time of your life.
Yeah, thanks, Ben. Yeah, it was, yeah, one of the best kind of surfs I've had in a competition, and just, yeah, it was just amazing to be able to go out there and express yourself on really big waves that are very critical. And I'm just stoked to have got into the final and to have got a second.
Well, you surfed incredible in that final. I've got to say, if you're up against anyone else, I think you'd be the winner. There's no doubt about it. So hold your head high, mate, and congratulations on the great day of surfing.
Thanks, Ben.
Okay.
Yeah, and Mathieu Babarit wanted Michael Osmond to win the contest because he knew that he was the man of the day. But you know, Mathieu is a competitor, and you can't beat Mathieu when he pushes his level as hard as he do.
I'm here with the champion, also known as the King, Mathieu Babarit. Mate, that was an amazing final. We all got to say that's the best final I've ever seen in wave ski surfing. How do you feel?
Thank you, Benny. Yeah, for sure, the final was heavy condition with Michael, so it was really nice to spend time with him. It was not fight final, it was really like a free session with Michael. We had pretty heavy and nice long waves. Yeah, I really enjoyed the conditions.
It's incredible, mate. I saw your quarter final when you creased your board, and you can see not so pretty anymore, mate. You got a bit of a cut there on the side, but
yeah.
To your credit. And then we had our semi-final, and you got absolutely trashed, and you got yourself up and going in that final, and to surf the way you did it, it's incredible, mate. I've never seen anything like it.
I think this is a great, crazy day, and aren't you bad, and say what a great day of surfing. Thank you.